Johnny Orlando Jr. here at the Palladium in Los Angeles for the Jeff Hanneman Memorial Celebration. Hi, I'm here with...
Tivu.
Tivu, can you tell me what Jeff Hanneman meant to you?
He meant freedom for everybody, rock and roll or otherwise.
The mood here is totally upbeat among the capacity crowd that wrapped all the way around the Palladium for a chance to pay tribute to Jeff. Not surprisingly, it was the loudest memorial service I've ever attended, and the first one to break out into a massive mosh pit. Eulogies were sometimes touching, sometimes hilarious.
Nobody's eating them. Nobody wants peas at a Slayer table. I don't know what the fuck they're there for, so, you know, we made them weapons.
Kerry King noted that it was ironic that the memorial service was being held at the Palladium because he and Jeff had been banned from the place for 20 years. Thanks, Satan, we brought our Zoom lens because otherwise we might not have noticed that Jeff Hanneman was actually in attendance. John, you were just explaining the different amps and guitars that were on stage and what eras they were from. Can you tell us about what we've got on stage?
Yeah, what we got on stage here is the big stack on the right are the amps from Random Blood era, 86, 87. And the amps on the left are the newer Mode 4 models, which they recently got like within the last 6 years, 8 years. So.
And then how about the guitars he's got up there?
Guitars are all guitars that he used on tour, studio. The two up front, you can see a Les Paul on the left. That's the original Les Paul from Southern Mercy days, you know. That's the old school Les Paul.
Oh, amazing.
And the Hanneman guitar on the right is his recent favorite guitar, which he played on all the tours from like the past 4 or 5 years. That was his baby.
Brian, what is your favorite memory of Jeff Hanneman?
Oh, wow. So that's a tough one. There's so many of them, but I'm going to say one of the later ones just because it was such a cool moment was the Big Four in Indio when Jeff went out for the last couple of songs and did Shout of Heaven. That was pretty amazing. It was good to see him up there, and he was so happy to be back up on stage. I always remember that. Just kind of, you get chills even thinking about it. I said so many memories, but that was a cool later one.
Yeah. What did Jeff mean to you? You've known him since the beginning of his career.
You know, you don't really reflect on these things, and it's kind of a bummer that you have to have something like this happen to kind of reflect, but such an amazing musician, and when you look at the body of work he did and what he wrote, so many of the riffs that he wrote, the songs that he wrote, really some of the greatest songs in metal history. So the fact that, you know, seeing this young little kid 30 some odd years ago become this guy who really changed the face of metal, it's just still kind of blows my mind. So it's really a bummer that you kind of got to think about that stuff now, but he really was insane, amazing.
What did Jeff Hanneman mean to you?
Well, I've been a diehard Slayer fan since 1983, and that band taught me and my partner Steve Perkins at the time was in Jane's Addiction quite a lot about being a unit and staying true to what you are no matter what the climate does around you. And the band was one of the most, I would say it was one of the most important door openings for me in terms of getting into other areas of metal. Mm-hmm. And I grew up as a metal kid, and I was in a speed metal band with our drummer since high school.
Wow.
And we just did Slayer covers, and you know, it's just what I love about the band is that it's just always remained consistently Slayer,
right,
no matter what happens in
right
the world.
Right.
So I think that in terms of artistry, that really speaks to me on a multitude of levels, but I wish more bands would take a cue from that here.
And if you had one word, just one word, that you could say to Jeff Hanneman right now, what would that word be?
I couldn't give you one word. Reanimate. Reanimate, that's the word.
And in case there was any doubt, the awesome food, awesome time, and awesome swag Slayer provided for their fans showed what a class act they are.